Hi. In this episode, we will try to understand the superelevation, the radial acceleration, centrifugal force, and also we will see how to calculate the required superelevation, minimum radius required, maximum permissible speed, length of transition curve required, and the limitations on the above. Welcome to Civil Guru. These videos made in different languages, like English, Hindi, Tamil, and also in Arabic now. Please choose your desired language from our playlist. If you like this video, please like and subscribe now, and share it with your friends. Thank you. In this episode, we will see about the superelevation. The transition curves are used to implement the superelevation and to connect a straight line with a sharp curve simultaneously. It starts with a straight line and gradually changes the radius from infinity to the required radius. First, we will try to analyze and understand the phenomenon of superelevation. While a vehicle is traveling on a curved road, the vehicle has a tendency to travel in a straight direction, which is tangential to the curve. As a result, the vehicle is subjected to a constant radial acceleration. Due to that radial acceleration, the vehicle is exposed to two different forces. The first one is weight of the vehicle, which is denoted as W. We knew that the weight always distributes the load vertical to the surface due to gravity. And the second is centrifugal force, which is denoted as P. Due to the radial acceleration, an external force is generated that is known as centrifugal force. This force acts perpendicular to the vertical axis of the vehicle. Due to this centrifugal force, the vehicle is slightly tilted towards inner side, and the outer side of the vehicle is slightly elevated. Due to that, the reactions are not in equilibrium condition. The inner wheels carries the entire load of vehicle, and the outer wheel becomes free and floating on the air. This will cause to lose the control on the vehicle and lead to the accident. To counteract the effect of this centrifugal force and to bring it in equilibrium condition, we must elevate the outer edge of the pavement surface with respect to the inner edge. This phenomena is called as superelevation. Before going in detail, we must know the limitations on the designing of superelevation. Those are 1. The permissible speed, that is, the design speed. The maximum permissible speed in US, China, and Korea is 120 km per hour. Except these three countries, remaining all other countries are following, the maximum permissible speed is 100 km per hour. 2. The maximum superelevation. There is no fixed superelevation is followed universally. It is purely based on the speed and the radius. In US, the maximum permissible superelevation is 8%. And remaining all other counties follows the maximum permissible superelevation as 7% in plain areas, and may vary in the country and hilly roads. However, must control by the speed and radius. 3. The minimum radius. The minimum radius in expressway shall be not less than 300 meters in plain area. It could be less in country roads, and also in urban and hilly areas by controlling the speed of the traffic. Now, let us study in detail and derive some important formulas. The weight of the vehicle is known or measurable, so we will calculate the centrifugal force. Let us recollect our memories of school days, which we have studied about the radial acceleration equals V square divided by R. Here, V is the velocity in meters per second, and R is the radius of curve in meters. This radial acceleration produces a centrifugal force, which acts in a radial direction, that pulls the vehicle away from the center. As we know from the school days, the value of any force equals mass into acceleration. Similarly here, the centrifugal force, P, equals mass into acceleration. Now, mass equals W divided by G. Here, W equals weight of the vehicle and G equals acceleration due to gravity. Now, centrifugal force, P, equals W divided by G into V square divided by R. That is, WV square divided by GR. Or, P divided by W equals V square divided by GR. The ratio between the centrifugal force and the weight of the vehicle is known as the centrifugal ratio. That is, P by W equals V square by GR. For highways, the ideal centrifugal ratio considered as 1 by 4. And for railways, it is 1 by 8. At the equilibrium state, the load of the vehicle will be carried by both the wheels equally. In such a condition, the vertical axis of the vehicle will be perpendicular to the surface of the pavement. That means the resultant will be normal to the pavement surface. Now, the inclination angle between weight W and the resultant R is known as theta. Considering this rectangle as equilibrium, the angle at the opposite direction is equivalent to theta. And also, the inclination between normal pavement surface to inclined surface is equivalent to theta. Again, we will go to school days memories, that is, the tan theta equals opposite side by adjacent side. Accordingly, considering this triangle, tan theta equals P by W. We already knew that the value of P by W equals V square by GR. And now, considering this triangle, the tan theta equals superelevation E by the width of the pavement B. That is, E by B equals tan theta. Now, E equals B into tan theta. If we substitute the tan theta value as V square by GR, then E equals B V square by GR. Here, we must remember that all the input values are in meters. Such as, the width of the road, B, is in meters. And the speed of the vehicle, V, in meters per second. And the radius of the curve is in meters. So, the value of E arrived here also in meters. In case the given speed of the vehicle is in kilometer per hour, then we must convert that into meters per second. The conversion factors are 1000 meters by 60 minutes into 60 seconds. That equals to 0.278 meters per second. Multiply the design speed given in kilometer per hour with this value. That gives the value in meters per second. For a designing engineer, it is important to provide a smooth traffic flow. That means the vehicle shall move normally without reducing the speed, even in the curves. For that, we must provide a sufficient and smooth radius on the curves to accommodate the vehicle's in design speed. So, we have to calculate the minimum radius required according to the design speed. In case, at unavoidable site conditions, the required radius, as per the design, is not able to provide. And if it is less than the required, then we must reduce the speed of the traffic to accommodate the vehicle's speed suitable to the radius provided. In such a case, we must calculate the maximum permissible speed suitable to the radius provided as per the site conditions. In such a situation, the divers shall be informed well in advance by proper signboards. First, let us see how to calculate the minimum radius required. There are two methods to follow. One is the method of maximum friction, and the second is by using maximum superelevation. Here, we will follow the second method, which is by maximum superelevation. In this method, the entire centrifugal force is balanced by the superelevation only. That is the equilibrium state. That means there will be zero friction on the surface of the pavement. Accordingly, as we already know, tan theta equals v square by gr. So, the radius r equals v square by g into tan theta. Second, we will see how to calculate the maximum permissible speed. We already knew that the centrifugal ratio and the ideal ratio for roads, that is p by w equals v square by gr, and the ideal ratio equals 1 by 4. Now, v square equals gr by 4. Finally, v equals square root of gr by 4. Now, let us calculate the length of the transition curve. Or, we can call this as the safer length is required to implement the superelevation. There are three methods available to calculate the length of the transition curve. 1. By an arbitrary gradient method. 2. By the time rate method. 3. By the rate of change of radial acceleration. Out of these three methods, the third method is most commonly used. So, we will analyze here by using the rate of change of radial acceleration method. In this method, the length of the transition curve is decided on the basis of the comfort of the passengers. That is, by applying the rate of change of acceleration. For that, first, we have to find the value of the rate of change of radial acceleration, which is denoted as alpha. The formula to find the alpha is 80 divided by 75 plus V. Here, V equals design speed of vehicle in kilometer per hour. For mixed velocity of vehicles passing on the same carriageway, the 75% of the design speed is considered as safe. This will give the values in between 0.5 to 0.8. The value arrived here is in meters. The fresh engineers must remember this formula, because this question is repeatedly asked in many entrance exams. And most of the textbooks never give this details. Mr. Short is highly professional. He states that, in his experience, the rate of change of radial acceleration of 1 foot, which is 0.3 meters per second, is the most ideal, and will pass unnoticed by passengers. That means alpha equals 0.3 meters. However, it is mostly used in railways only, because the length of the train is longer than highway vehicles. So, the long transition curves help the train to keep in control. Now, let us calculate the length of the transition curve. The time consumed to travel over the transition curve is T. That is, L by V, seconds. The acceleration attained within that time equals alpha into T. That is, alpha into L by V, meters per second square. We know that the radial acceleration of the circular curve equals V square by R, which is in meters per second square. That is, alpha, L by V, equals V square by R. Now, L equals V cubed by alpha, R. Here, the V equals meters per second. This value is considered as the minimum length required. And, according to Mr. Short's statement, the length L equals V cubed by 0.3 R. This length is considered as the maximum length. For highways, we can choose any numbers in between these two values as per the site condition. And that is considered as the safe length. If you like these videos, please subscribe now and share with your friends. And also don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.